Orioles get the shutout 2-0, and Brad Brock comes on to get the save. Brad, congratulations.
Thank you. Thanks.
Hey, let's get a scouting report from you on another pitcher. How about Dylan Bundy here, not just tonight, but in his starts?
Yeah, he's been incredible. I mean, every time he's gone out there, he's given us a chance to win, and that's not an easy lineup he faced tonight. He went out there like he's a veteran, and he shoved, and that was awesome to see.
Well, Brad, you've been a dominant setup man for a couple years now. Sliding into the save role, nothing's changed. Still very dominant.
Oh, yeah, thanks. I'm trying not to treat it any different. I'm pretending it's the eighth inning right now, and when Zach comes back, he'll take back over. But it's fun. I like closing. It's exciting out there.
Yeah, swing and miss stuff. How about your usage of pitches? What pitch do you feel good with right now?
You know, the fastball, the hitters just can't seem to catch up to it. They seem a little bit late right now, but I think this is the best I've felt with all three. I feel like I have command of both sides of the plate with all three pitches, and luckily for me, I'm pitching one inning, so if I can go out there and I can locate those pitches, it's going to be a tough outing for the other team.
Brad, does anything change for you in the closing role as far as your choice of pitchers or your approach to the hitters?
Not really. I think I just get extra aggressive because I don't want to walk a guy. I don't want to put a guy on base, especially tonight with a two-run game. You don't ever want to put a guy on free pass. That's why I got behind Hanley there, and I just wanted to attack the zone. And, you know, if they hit a solo home run there, I'm not too concerned about it, and I just got to go after the next hitter. So I think that's been the biggest difference is just attacking the zone and going right after him.
Well, congratulations. Thank you.
Thank you, guys.